Without further ado, let us welcome our second evaluator for Jack Ng, Advanced Communicator Silver, Advanced Leader Bronze, Emil Antony.
My time is not up yet. Toastmaster Jack, get to the point, project speech number 3. Your title was Verbal English. You had 2 purposes in your speech today. One was to have a general purpose, and secondly, to have a specific purpose within your speech. How well did you do? First and foremost, let me congratulate you. You had a very good vocal. Everyone here could hear you speak audibly. Your pronunciation was fair for a Malaysian ear, such as mine. And you are a natural and humorous speaker. You came here, you started by asking a question. Has anyone asked you to repeat again when you spoke to them? You paused, you waited for an answer. So you had an interactive relationship with the audience. Very well done. And then you moved on by putting in a humorous, how you say, you define your English as OMG, oh my God. And you moved on by telling us that English is the 3rd most spoken language in the world. Now once you have stated this, you have actually created a need. What is verbal English? It's the 3rd most spoken language in the world, and why we need to listen to your speech. Once you have created a need, you gave us the tools, the 3 P's. The first P was pronunciation. And you gave us a session on words that can be used, where we should focus on our diction, especially when you pronounce something, and you gave us a lot of examples. From pronunciation, you went on to pace and practice. You did very well, excellent. Now, because this is your 3rd speech, let me give you some feedback how to improve. Because you had an interactive session and you had 3 specific purposes, which was to let people focus on pronunciation, pace, and practice. So try to break it evenly for each. Now for the pronunciation, rather than having a lot, maybe have 3 and choose a specific person to pronounce it for you and then correct it and move on. So you can cut on time when you do your speech. Second is the space, and you told us about the monotony of your speech, and you gave example how you work in the call center. By the time you finish your 3-minute sales speech and the person asks you to repeat yourself. So probably you can put in a pace which is faster and slower, so that when you deliver your speech with us today, the pace is up and low. And finally was practice. For practice, I thought it would be very suitable if you put in a story. People can always relate a story. One story that I can think for you is for practice is when Tiger Woods hit the ball, it enters hole in one, and they say it's lucky, and they say do it again, and he hits again and exactly hole in one again. Say, no, that's definitely lucky. Again, they tell him to do it, and the 3rd time he hits and he goes hole in one. And Tiger Woods says this: the more I practice, the luckier I get. Now you have reinforced your message. And finally, you delivered very well, but I thought you were dancing and prancing on the stage. If you could just plant yourself, have a stance, and deliver your speech, it would be very good. Overall, I learned a lot from you. You are naturally humorous, you fulfill all your goals. And I can see that you're a budding great speaker on the horizon who will give all his English Toastmasters a run for their money. Thank you.
Mentioned about the pace, so you want to slow down a little so that we can follow you better throughout this speech.